Okay, let's continue our path of destruction, of destroying Ketcha Watches. I'm going to think it's going to be pretty easy with the Lance. It's got solid green sharpness, decent enough attack power, the ability to counter, which against Ketcha Watcher should be pretty decent. You know he's always going to try and swipe at you from when he's turning around. If he doesn't, you could always counter-cancel into an attack anyways. Opinion is still out on whether or not I should be sticking around in 2, but trying to track him down in 4. It's like seconds. Seconds of timing. So I think the first time I fought him in a non-cutscene, we had just passed each other. Like he was flying over my head as I entered into 4. Can we get him? We can! He just ran away anyways. That's bizarre. Why would you do that? He's not even in 2. Where did you go? It's gotta be a 9, right? It has to be. I am so sorry. I mean, it did kind of look like he went in the direction of 8, but I didn't know you could fight him there. When I first started getting into Monster Hunter multiplayer, I didn't even really care about the fact that, you know, you'd have multiple times the damage getting onto the monster. My whole thing was entirely, oh, when a monster runs, you could have 4 people go into 4 different zones. That way you can always find the monster. I might try and ride him again. Oop! Broke his tail while he was going up in the air. Caused a great flinch. Also counter-canceled through his roar. I guess that wasn't a counter-cancel, that was just a normal counter. Oop, not through that one though. He might resist getting knocked down now because I had just done it to him a little bit ago. Not really a big deal. He did that rather quickly. Really hard to aim that, as you can imagine. Alright, I don't really want to fight him at the zone line, so I'm just going to let him do his own thing for a second there. It's a serious pet peeve of certain players, believe it or not. They get really angry if you're fighting a monster while they're stuck in the borderline. But you can, you know, I can't really blame them. I mean, it's a chance to lose your carves. You're constantly zoning in and out for no reason. face. So creepy. Is there a chance? No. No, stop hitting me. Oh god. Getting snotted all over the place. It's like a monkey Rathalos. Hovering in the air, blasting you with snot balls. You'll notice I use the sweeping attack a lot more. I can't remember if it was the case in the other Monster Hunters, but you can actually combo that multiple times now. You can't chain them right after each other, but you can follow it up with another attack. And my philosophy has always been, you know, any attack's better than no attack. I really gotta get a ride off if I wanna get that subquest reward. Oh, there we go. It's finally a system in the game that's good for button mashers. Oop, I kinda tricked us out a little bit. You notice you kind of still maintain your charge when going between different levels of area. That's kind of a pretty cool bonus. Alright, we'll just attack his hand, cause him to trip. Okay, there we go. I think that was one of the smoothest fights I've had with him so far. Not too many things left. Charge Axe, Insect Staff, Bowgun. Should be pretty easy, pretty straightforward. Actually, we don't want to fight those guys. We want to get ourselves more ore. This stuff here. Be excited to finally be able to upgrade one of my lances. I think I can go down the bone line now with him. We'll see. There's got to be something I can do